the Prophet Muhammad, peace and blessings be upon him, said, none of you has faith until you love for your neighbor what you love for yourself. All my life, every day, I have heard and used the greetings, Assalamu alaikum. A wish for the other to be blessed with peace.
Jordan is a Muslim country with a deep-rooted Christian community that dates back, a couple of thousand years.
We were never raised up to be a disconnected country, a country that wants to live alone.
The king being a Hashemite has a particular standing in this because of the fact that he is of the Prophet's family.
The Hashemites trace their lineage directly to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, peace be upon him. This gives them the legitimacy, the credentials that are required to initiate dialogue between civilizations and religions.
Jordan's not a big country, but its leaders have been big leaders. With a big vision, King Hussein, now King Abdullah, have been open to dialogue with their neighbors and with the rest of the world. And in so doing, have become great emissaries, not just for Jordan, but for Islam.
It was Zarqawi, of course, his group who were responsible for the bombings. And he exemplified a particularly savage turn in the Takfiri jihad inside Iraq. But he also wanted to spread this more widely around the region, which was the point of the hotel bombings in Jordan. I think he wanted to destabilize Jordan in the way that he thought he was destabilizing Iraq.
This was not the first time that Jordan was the target of terrorism, but perhaps this was the first time that we faced the new face of this radicalized ideology. And His Majesty the King felt that he needed to do something.
كنا بالعالم بوضع حرب بين الاعتدال والتطرف بكل دول العالم. لأنه اليوم عندنا حرب أهلية داخل الإسلام. للأسف بجوز الدول العربية ونحن كعرب ومسلمين حتى الآن مش حاسين إنه هيك الوضع، لكن حرب الأمني بيجي بتاخدنا 5 إلى 10، الحرب الأيديولوجية راح تاخدنا وقت.
So events after 2001 sent the world system reeling. You had the 9/11 attacks, obviously. You had the 7/7 bombings. You had the Madrid train bombings. You had the Afghanistan war. You had the Iraq war. King Abdullah recognizes that Muslims themselves need to have a conversation about what's actually happening here. And that process culminates in the Amman message.
You know, the Amman message was the first attempt to bring together a set of established Islamic scholars and Islamic scholarly institutions around the world.
في محاور الرسالة خاطبت الناس جميعا، وبالتالي بينت أن الله تعالى جعل للإنسان كرامة. ماذا يعني الإسلام؟ عدم جواز تكفير الآخر. الإسلام انبنى على التعددية، على التسامح، على احترام الآخر، إلى غير ذلك من المحاور التي وردت في هذه الرسالة.
I think it is something you need to build on. I mean, this is not something that can stand still.
It requires education, it requires enlightenment, it requires revision of our of our understanding of our religious values, of our religious teachings.
لكن قد يكون هناك عبء كبير جدا على مسألة المسجد والفتوى بالذات في رسم معالم الثقافة الإسلامية المعتدلة. يمكن لأئمة المساجد أن يقدموا هذا الخطاب.
So the Iman message is a dialogue aimed at Muslims, by Muslims, for Muslims, about their religion. But you have this concurrent rise of tensions between the global Muslim community and the global Christian community. And sensing this, King Abdullah launched the Common Word Initiative.
His Majesty invited 138 Muslim scholars from the different six sects. They addressed the Christian world that the core of religion is loving God and loving the neighbor.
If you begin a dialogue by understanding that we have some first principles in common, love God, love your neighbor, then you can go on to a dialogue about the issues that divide you, understanding that the result is not that you suddenly agree on everything, but that you treat each other with respect.
فإنني أدعوكم إلى تعزيز مسيرة الحوار بين الأديان والتركيز على تعظيم الجوامع المشتركة بين أتباع الديانات والمذاهب.
عشان هيك رسالة عمان هي مش بس توضيح الإسلام، ولكن هي كمان رسالة اللي بتفرجي كيف نحن عايشين في الأردن.
What His Majesty always talks about is if you want to reclaim a narrative, you have to put yourself out there. You have to do it online, you have to do it offline, you have to do it by leading by example.
For the king, managing these stresses, managing these conflicts, and coming through with such resilience has been one of the most remarkable achievements of the modern Middle East.
The values we share, equality, compassion, hope, need to be connected to everything we do. And we must keep ourselves connected to each other for the good of all.